Ed Kentner, Riding with Drivers. Today's episode features Eric Rogers. He's our May Driver of the Month. Eric, why don't you tell us a little bit about yourself and how you ended up coming to National Carriers?
Came to National Carriers because of the area I live in and the money and the home time when I'm able to take it. 43 years old and been pretty much doing this since 92. Not much to tell about myself. I just do what I got to do. And about it, really. I'm just here for the money.
All right, well, you are in our lease program. Let's talk about that a little bit. First of all, is that what brought you to National Carriers, or is that something you decided to do once you got here?
No, it's what brought me. It's, I like the freedom and the chances to make my own decisions instead of basically being told that this is what I'm going to do, where I'm going to fuel, this is the load I'm taking. You know, if I don't want to take it, I don't have to.
You are in a Kenworth?
2016 T680.
And your Kenworth is equipped with Easy Pre-Pass?
Yes.
It is equipped with satellite communication?
Yes.
You have the ability to do all your routing?
Correct.
On board?
Yep.
What other features does this particular truck offer you that you find very beneficial for your trucking business?
For one, the refrigerator back there, that's a big help. Two, the inverter. Of course, you got the built-in computer here, you know, the for the e-logs and all that. You know, it's got a built-in Garmin GPS with it also. An air conditioner and heater, that's a bonus there.
What interests you in our lease program that made you want to come over to start with? And second of all, what benefits have you found being in our leasing program?
The main thing that brought me over here was the money. You know, the way that I get paid weekly, and it is really good money. You just gotta keep the door shut and the wheels rolling. You know, if you want to be home every night and all, you're not gonna make the money. You know, that's a given with any company. But I basically, just like a company driver, only I have twice the expenses or all the expenses, and the way I get paid a little bit better for it. It's the only way I can really honestly work it.
Let's look at it from another angle, from a tax angle. Is it any benefit to being the owner of the truck, or is it about the same as being a company guy?
As far as taxes go, you need to save every receipt for one. I mean, I don't care if you spend 5 cents on a piece of bubble gum, get a receipt for it. I mean, honestly, nitpick everything. But other than that, you know, I like to say my biggest paycheck comes at the end of the year. You know, a lot of people, you know, we got to pay every quarter, or we're supposed to. A lot of people don't, but, you know, you pay it, you get money back at the end of the year, versus a company driver that the company automatically takes the taxes out for them. They don't have the headache like I do. I have to do it all on my own. More rewards for what I, you know, the work I put in.
Being part of the National Carriers Network for repairs, for fuel, those type things, have you found that to be beneficial for you?
You know, you got to consider the age of the trucks like this one, you know, 90% of it's still under warranty, which is good. So the money that I pay in for maintenance basically covers like tires, oil changes, windshields, I've had to have them replaced, you know, stuff like that. It's a 2-year lease, and the completion bonus is off of, they figure it off your loaded miles. Mine on this particular truck was just a hair over $2,400, which is really good. The first lease that I completed, it was just shy of $2,000, but it works out pretty good. It's extra money that comes in handy, that's for sure. Like I said earlier, you know, I do the same job a company driver does. I want to get paid for it. I mean, every person has their own individual problems at home or whatever, you know, expenses I should say, and the only way I can cover mine is to do it this way. I get paid more to do it, and like I said, my biggest one comes at the end of the year. I mean, I do get a settlement every week, providing I work and don't sit at home, but you know, at the end of the year, it's kind of like getting a completion bonus every year, the way, if you want to look at it that way. I have no complaints there. I mean, the only time that I don't get the revenue you know, that I want is usually when I take a day or two off at home. And then, you know, that's a given. You can't make money sitting at home, but you've got to crawl out of the truck every now and then, just kind of get your mind right again. The only way you're going to make any money is keeping the wheels rolling, the door shut and the wheels rolling. Got chunky cheeks when you look at it. Little baby cheeks there.